Time goes on, FFA members go through their 4 years of high school and eventually will leave. But one thing stays the same, and that is our advisors. They give us the support and care that is unique to any other individual that we come in contact with. Here to introduce our state president, Riley Gerrits, for a retiring address is her advisor, Mr. Mark Badia.
There's a reason that advisors don't normally do this. The letter read, April 22nd, 2011. Dear Mr. Badia, my name is Riley Gerrits, and I'm currently an eighth grader at William Thomas Middle School. I will be signing up for Ag 110 this year as I begin my high school career. I've done speech and debate through middle school, but have heard that the FFA offers leadership opportunities found nowhere else, so I plan to take advantage of all of those that I can. I also plan to be a veterinarian when I'm all done with school, so I'll be taking advantage of all the science curriculum the Ag program has as well. I am interested in being a freshman representative on the chapter officer team, but will be unable to attend the chapter officer retreat this summer, as I've already committed to teaching an ecology workshop at the same time. I look forward to meeting you in the months to come and hope that you can help me achieve the goals that I have set for myself. Sincerely, Riley. I've never received a letter like that before, nor have I since. But then I've never had a student quite like Riley Gerrits. As I've come to know her these past 6 years, I found in her so many exceptional qualities. If you've had the opportunity to know her as well, you know that she has the compassion of a saint and the ability to convince you that anything is possible. Yet for all her gifts, she has one glaring and sometimes deeply troubling character flaw. It's a flaw that she and I share. It's one that we have come to talk about a lot this past year as she's come to see herself and realize it for what it was. It's not one that you'll likely notice unless you know her, for she almost always internalizes it. I've probably made it worse over the years as I prodded her and pushed her towards a goal that she asked me to help her achieve in the letter. It's not my place to tell you the flaw that Riley and I share, it's hers. What I will tell you is that there are no shortcuts in life nor in leadership, and Riley has taken none. She has only met her goals because of her tenacious work ethic, coupled with her ability to self-evaluate and modify a course of action as needed. The latter is uncommon in a person of any age. As you listen to Riley's retiring address, the flaw that she and I share will become evident. Some of you may recognize it in yourself. It can be changed, but it will take a conscious effort on our parts. I am so proud of Riley, not because she's my student, but because of the path that she has chosen to take, a life dedicated to the service of others, specifically you, Idaho FFA. FFA members and guests, any advisor in this room will tell you, and mean it, that as teachers, we spend our entire career in search of students like Riley Gerrits. Students who choose to make the full advantage of what we offer, and in doing so, become better than either of us thought possible. Excuse me. Students who are committed to seeing things through with the very best effort. Students like many of you who have dreams and goals and will work tirelessly to fulfill them. FFA members, when you have some quiet time, reflect on your dreams and goals and how they can be achieved. Those dreams and goals will find your purpose, and in doing so, find the ability to dedicate yourself to each moment that you live, to each of those dreams and goals. FFA members, parents, and guests, it's my sincerest honor to introduce for her retiring address, entitled 100 Years, your 2015-2016 State President, Riley Gerrits.
just dreaming, counting the ways to where you are. I'm 22 for a moment, and she feels better than ever.
I had a to-do list. At the end of my 100 years, I wanted to have accomplished many different things. Top of my class, doctor of veterinary medicine, first female governor of Idaho, and eventually the president of the United States. But in all my efforts to dedicate all that I had to these goals, I swear I didn't notice the days going by. I was so focused on dedicating all that I had to these goals that I missed out on all the beauty that occurred in the time between them. Those unremarkable, everyday life moments that are small, but have the ability to bring us the biggest amount of joy. Like the feeling of warmth and love I get every time I make sugar cookies with my grandma Karen. Or the way it feels to pat the hair or fix the collar of a nervous FFA member about to give their first speech. Or the rush of pride I get every time I get to watch my sister's team win a basketball game. The little things that, when done intentionally, have the ability to bring us the biggest amount of joy. So, I have a question for you. Is it more important that we have years in our life or life in our years? How about I introduce you to the kid who is the living answer to that very question? The first time I met the one I call my life coach, a 10-year-old boy named Garrett, I felt like I was a somebody. His little feet pitter-pattered up the walk. He threw open the front door, laid his eyes on me for the first time, and jumped into my rather unexpected arms, saying two things that I will never forget. One, that I was somehow the most beautiful girl in the entire world. And two, that he loved me. In awe, I remember just standing there, holding him, wondering what had compelled him to say those powerful things to a complete stranger, one who had done nothing to deserve that. Yet Garrett that day seemed to see me for who I really was. And that was somebody who desperately needed him to teach me a lesson. A lesson that, in a lot of ways, saved my life. You see, while most of us grew up playing outside at recess with friends or hanging out in the backyard, Garrett spent his short childhood in and out of hospital rooms as he grew sicker and sicker, yet nobody knew why. The battles that most little boys fight are against imaginary dragons or pirates with big swords. Yet, Garrett's opponent is his own body. Most of our parents get to watch us grow up through pictures in Dad's wallet or a window that faces outside into a big grassy backyard. Yet, for 10 years, Clara Lee and Oscar have watched Garrett just fight to survive, and getting to grow up, start a family, and achieve his dreams is not something we choose to focus on with Garrett, because for him, it's just not a reality. Due to a rare mitochondrial disease affecting his whole body, my life coach has been fighting an uphill battle. A battle that is painful, merciless, and quite frankly, absolutely heartbreaking. A battle that ultimately Garrett will lose. What happened to Garrett's 100 years? Why doesn't he get to grow up and become somebody? These were two of the questions I asked Clara Lee the night my world stopped turning when I found out at 212 through 60 in Pocatello. When God didn't answer my questions, I asked them to her the next morning in the hotel bathroom, and when she didn't answer, it fell apart. When I let her go, even though it wasn't fair and absolutely isn't fair, Clara Lee was bravely smiling, convinced that there was hope still. I slowly felt my perspective on my 100-year shift is that life coach of mine taught me how to put moments into every second of my life I'm given. You see, when we focus on doing this, we stop worrying so much about what we want and we need and more look externally at the world around us. We spend our time FaceTiming to say our bedtime prayers, just like me and Garrett do, or chasing each other around the backyard in matching outfits looking for imaginary tornadoes. We suddenly spend our time hugging or playing or praising or serving. We see the beauty in the small ways that we can lift each other up. My friends, what matters is not the glory that we can acquire for ourselves, but the acts of kindness and love that can give glory to our God and spread hope into a very broken world. I want to be someone who doesn't just add years to life, but adds life to our years. Like Kelly, like Reuben, like Hunter, Tanner, Michaela, I want to be someone adding life to years. Not just to my own years, though. To the years of other people. And every day, Idaho FFA, our ag teachers do just that. FFA members, I want you to stand up right now if your ag teacher has ever inspired you, cared about you, loved you, challenged you, or made you better. Look around. That is phenomenal. We can go ahead and be seated. My friends, those people gave up years of their life to add life to your years. It was watching my ag teacher, Mr. Badia, believe so fiercely in a lost freshman girl that gave me the courage to stand up here right now in front of you and say, my name is Riley Elena Garretts, and when I grow up, I am going to teach ag. Why? Because I want to be adding someone life to someone's years. For 4 years, every spare ounce of intention he had was dedicated to making sure our lambs were trimmed for fair, our speeches were perfected, and most importantly, our hearts were never left lonely, broken, hurting, or confused. And on the road this year, I watched all of your teachers do the same thing. Oh, nothing compared to the way their eyes would light up from the back of the room when you would answer a question correctly. Or the way they would talk with a tone of pride in their voice when they would tell my teammates and I about all you had accomplished. Lives lived like Garrett or like an ag teacher are timeless. You see, it is impossible to add length to our lives. Rather, these people focus on giving them depth and width. The way they do this is immeasurable. It's focusing not so much on the big things, but on the time that comes between them, and Garrett and I have shared a lot of these moments. From staying up late to the middle of the night playing Taylor Swift on guitar together, or getting up early to watch the sunrise from a trampoline. What about you? Are you adding life to your years by focusing on what truly matters? Do you actually look your parents in the eye when you tell them I love you in the morning, or are you on your way out the door? Is asking somebody how they are intentional, or is it just something that we have to do? And then when they answer, do you actually listen? Can you put aside your frustration with that lamb or that steer long enough to just watch the sunset on a cool July evening when you're getting ready for fair? Are you enjoying every moment you get to zip up your jacket, or are you rushing to breakfast so you can rush to the bus so you can rush to an event? So much of our lives are spent rushing and counting down the moments till we can check off that next item on our to-do list. Stop wishing away your life and instead fill it. Fill it with love, fill it with joy, fill it with intention. Fill every moment you are given. Idaho FFA, we may not get to live 100 years, but if we live every moment like Garrett or like an ag teacher, we don't need 100 years to be fulfilled. Speaking of Garrett, I asked him for a little help on how to end this speech because I wasn't sure how to do it. And he told me to tell you one thing, and that was that I loved you. Idaho FFA, I love you. So much so that I spent 31,560,000 seconds serving you this past year, and thank you for putting 100 years into every single one.
The chair recognizes the delegate from the American Falls chapter.
Riley, you have helped all of us in our chapter grow as leaders, and this year you have done that throughout the state. Mr. Chair, I move to accept Riley Garrett's retiring address entitled 100 Years and commend her on a job remarkably well done.
Let the conference minutes show that Riley Garrett's retiring address entitled 100 Years was unanimously accepted and that she's to be commended on a job remarkably well done. Riley, your true passion in serving for people and your ability to connect with others is one I believe I can speak for a whole team that we are envious of. You have served this year with just complete uniqueness that is something that only you could bring. Thank you so much for being such a great part of our team. Idaho FFA, for the final time, your 2015-2016 State President, Riley Garrett.
To live.